20 shift shortcuts in After Effects in under 7 minutes. Let's do this. To fit your comp to the viewer, use shift slash. If I zoom in too tight, shift slash brings it back so it fits into our viewer. And also if I'm too wide, shift slash brings it back. I'm going to put a keyframe for position, and the next tip is shift page down, jumps forward 10 frames, and then also shift page up, goes backwards 10 frames. To call up more than one transform property, hold down shift and press S for scale, R for rotation, T for opacity, or A for anchor point. If I want to animate this text on from the left, I have to scrub to the left like this. If you simply grab your text and then hold down shift and move to the left, you can move it off camera super quick. And this goes for every direction. The main thing to remember with this is to start to move your text first. Then I hit shift and it will snap right to that path. And one of the most common function shortcuts you might know is F9. That makes any keyframe Bezier. If you hold down shift F9, you'll get an easy ease in. And just so you know, if you add a command or control to that, you'll get an easy out keyframe. Now, one of the things I do quite often is I will toggle over to our graph editor, which is this icon right here. Shift F3 pulls up your graph editor. It also hides it and brings you back to your timeline. I want to parent this to this other text layer. There's no parent column right here. Shift F4 will bring up your parent column, and let's just parent that top layer to that second layer. You may need to take a snapshot to show your client your progress. Shift F5, 6, 7, or 8, take snapshots. Select your comp viewer, shift period on your keyboard, jumps through your comps from left to right, and shift comma jumps from right to left. If you zoom in first all the way to your timeline, then use shift colon, you can now toggle from being zoomed all the way in to all the way out. So you have to zoom in first. If you tend to zoom in about halfway and now use shift colon, it will only zoom in to that point. Whenever you choose shift colon the second time, it will zoom all the way out, but you can control where it zooms into. Shift quotation marks pulls up your grid. If you hold down shift and scrub through position, it will jump by 10 pixels. If I'm not holding down anything, scrubbing through moves by 1 pixel. Holding down command scrubs through by 1/10 of a pixel. And this works for every property value: position, scale, rotation, opacity, and anchor point. Hold down shift S to bring up my scale. If I start to increase it, it will go up by 1 pixel. Hold down shift, it will jump by 10 pixels. Hold down command, it will jump by 1/10 of a pixel. Another shortcut for moving position is to hold down shift and use your right and left arrow keys. Using the plus and minus keys on your number pad will rotate by 1 degree. If you hold down shift, it will rotate by 10 degrees. Grab your rotation tool, start to rotate it, and then hold down shift, and it will jump by 45 degrees. I'm going to pull in this texture. If you hold down shift and use your plus or minus keys on your keyboard, it will cycle through your blend modes. I'm going to grab my ellipse tool. If you start to create a shape, you can make this in any dimension that you want. Hold down shift and it will make a perfect shape. And this goes for ellipses, rectangles, and polystars. If you add a command or control to that, it will now create a perfect shape from wherever your cursor was. Just to show you, if I start to make it again, but only hold down shift, it creates it from the corner, depending on which direction that you go out. In this case, I always add in a command or control, so that way it creates the shape from where my cursor is. I'm going to make multiple copies of this solid here. Again, with a number pad, if you select a number, it will jump to that layer, and it even works with double digits. The shift shortcut selects all the layers that you choose while holding down shift. Still holding down shift, hit 7, and it makes 7 unselected. Select 7 again, and it selects the layer. So you can select as many layers as you want and deselect them simply by holding down shift and using the numbers on your number pad. I'm going to add in a camera. Holding down shift and pressing 1, 2, or 3 on your keyboard will select your camera tools. Shift 1 selects your orbit tool, shift 2 selects the pan tool, and shift 3 selects the dolly tool. And again, these are the numbers on your keyboard. Hold down shift and then press any number, it will create a marker with that number. So with my cursor at the 7th marker, if I type shift 5, that marker now becomes the 5th marker, and marker numbered 5 disappears when we do that. So a quick way to create markers is to hold down shift and use your numbers on your keyboard. The thing that's interesting about this shortcut is that if I hold shift 3, 2, or 1, it does not create a marker, but you can see that it's toggling through our camera tools. But if you go up to your settings, go down to 3D, you'll see that this use 1, 2, 3 for navigation and 4, 5, 6 for transform gizmos is selected by default. Now, if you take that off, now you can use shift 1 to create a marker for 1, shift 2, and shift 3. And your camera tools are no longer selected. And one of the other cool things is that whenever you disable that function, you can now use the numbers on your keyboard to jump to specific markers. So I'm going to press 5, 7 jumps down to 7, 1 goes to 1. And I'm using the numbers on my keyboard. This is extremely helpful whenever you use markers to indicate the beginning or the end of an animation. So there you have it, 20 shift shortcuts that will save you time, speed up your workflow, and satisfy that little part of your brain that likes to nerd out on all things After Effects. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, is guaranteed to make you a Shape Layer Rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.